fundamental theorem on homomorphism of rings. The statement of this theorem is, every homomorphic image of a ring is isomorphic to some quotient ring thereof. Proof: let F be a homomorphism of a commutative ring R onto a ring R dash. Here R dash is a homomorphic image of R. Let S be the kernel of the function F. Then S is an ideal of R. Since S is an ideal, we can define the residue classes of R, namely R by S is a ring of residue classes of R relative to the ideal capital S. R by S is a quotient ring. For A belongs to R, consider this is the ring R having element A. S plus A belongs to R by S and F of A belongs to R dash. Therefore, for this R, we have R by S. From A belongs to R, we have S plus A belongs to R by S. For this A, F of A must be in R dash. Therefore, this is the ring R dash. And for this, we have a function f is from R to R dash such that f of A belongs to R dash. Now consider another mapping. Phi from R S to R dash. This is R by S. This is R dash. We are going to define a new function from R by S to R. That function is phi. And the phi is defined as phi of S plus A is equal to F of A for all A belong to R. That is, for A belongs to R, F of A belongs to R dash, S plus A belongs to R dash. Now we are going to relate these two, R by S and R dash, by the function phi such that phi of S plus A is equals to F of A. The elements of the ring are of the form A comma B comma C comma D, so on. The elements of R by S will be of the form, for A we have S plus A, for B we have S plus B, for C we have S plus C, so on. Therefore, elements of R by S are of the form S plus A, comma S plus B, comma S plus C, comma S plus D, so on. And the elements of R dash are of the form F of A, comma F of B, comma F of C, comma F of D, so on, where phi of S plus A is equals to F of A. So these are the structures of the elements of R, R by S and R dash respectively. Now we have to show that R by S is isomorphic to R dash. Phi is well defined. For this, consider two elements of R by S, namely S plus A and S plus B, and make them equal. Therefore, S plus A is equal to S plus B. We know that S plus A equal to S plus B if and only if A minus B belong to S. Therefore, now this implies A minus B belong to S. What is S? S is a kernel of F. Therefore, when we say A minus B belongs to S, F of A minus B equals to 0 dash. We know that S is kernel, so X belongs to S if and only if F of X is equal to 0 dash. Since A minus B belongs to S, we must have F of A minus B equals to 0 dash. This implies f of a plus of minus b equals to 0 dash. But what is f? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, f of a plus b is equal to f of a plus f of b. And hence, f of a plus of minus b equal to 0 becomes f of a plus f of minus b equal to 0 dash. Also, we know that f of minus b equal to minus of f of b. Therefore, this can be written as f of a minus f of b equal to 0 dash. This implies f of a equals to f of b. But what is f of a? F of a is nothing but, by definition of phi, f of a is nothing but phi of s plus a. What is f of b? F of b is equal to phi of s plus b. Thus, we have shown that s plus a equal to s plus b implies phi of s plus a equal to phi of s plus b. That is, whenever the two elements of R by S are equal and their images under the function phi is also equal, therefore we say that phi is well defined. We shall now show that phi is 1 to 1. To prove phi is 1 to 1, we have to show that if phi of s plus a equal to phi of s plus b, then s plus a must be equal to s plus b for all a comma b belong to R. That is, 1 to 1 is the reverse process of well defined. For a comma b belong to R, s plus a comma s plus b belongs to R by S. Now consider phi of s plus a equal to phi of s plus b. What is phi of s plus a? By definition of phi, phi of s plus a is f of a. Therefore, phi of s plus a equal to f of a, phi of s plus b equal to f of b. Therefore, this implies f of a equal to f of b. Now, transposing f of b to the left hand side, since f of a and f of b are elements of R dash, therefore f of a minus f of b equal to 0 dash, where 0 dash is the 0 element in R dash. Also, we know that f of minus b equal to minus of f of b. Therefore, this minus of f of b can be written as f of minus b, and hence this implies f of a plus f of minus b equal to 0 dash. What is f? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, f of a plus f of b equal to f of a plus b. Therefore, here we can write f of a plus minus b equals to 0. Therefore, we can write f of a plus minus b equal to 0 dash. That is, f of a plus into minus is minus. So, f of a minus b equals to 0 dash. Then, by definition of kernel, we know that if f of x is equal to 0 dash, then x must be in S. Therefore, here f of a minus b equal to 0 dash. Therefore, this a minus b must belong to S, where S is the kernel. Also, we know that a minus b belongs to S, implies and implied by S plus a equal to S plus b. Therefore, this can be written as S plus a equal to S plus b. Thus, we have started with phi of s plus a equal to phi of s plus b, and we have arrived at s plus a equal to s plus b. Therefore, we say that phi is 1 to 1. We shall now show that phi is onto. We know that a function f is from a to b is onto if for every b belongs to b, there exists a belongs to a such that the function is true. F of A equals to B. Therefore, to prove pi is onto V, how to show that for every y belongs to R dash, there exists S plus A from R by S such that the function is true. That is phi of S plus A equals to Y. So, choose Y belongs to R plus. That is the codomain ring. Since F is from R to R dash is onto homomorphism, for this Y belongs to R dash, there must exist an element A in capital R such that F of A equals to Y. And for this A belongs to R, we have S plus A belongs to R by S. And so, phi of S plus A is equals to F of A by definition of phi. But what is F of A? F of A equal to Y, which is an element of R dash. Thus, we have shown that for every Y belongs to R dash, there exists S plus A belongs to R by S such that phi of S plus A equals to Y. And hence, phi is onto. Now, the fourth part is phi is homomorphism. For A comma B belong to R, S plus A comma S plus B belong to R by S. To prove phi is a homomorphism, we have to show that phi of S plus A plus S plus B equals to phi of S plus A plus phi of S plus B. And phi of S plus A into S plus B equals to phi of S plus A into phi of S plus B. Now consider phi of S plus A plus S plus B. And we know that S plus A plus S plus B equals to S plus A plus B. And hence this can be written as phi of S plus A plus B. By the definition of phi, what is phi of S plus A? It is F of A. And hence phi of S plus A plus B will be F of A plus B. What is F? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, F of A plus B is nothing but F of A plus F of B. But what is F of A? F of A is phi of S plus A. What is F of B? By definition of phi, F of B is phi of S plus B. And hence, this equals to phi of S plus A plus phi of S plus B. Now we'll prove the second part, namely phi of S plus A into S plus B. We know that S plus A into S plus B is equal to S plus AB. And hence this can be written as phi of S plus AB. What is the definition of phi? Phi of S plus A is F of A. Therefore, phi of S plus AB is F of AB. This by definition of phi. What is F? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, F of A into B is F of A into F of B. But what is F of A? F of A is phi of S plus A. What is F of B? F of B is equal to phi of S plus B. Therefore, this equals to phi of S plus A into phi of S plus B by the definition of phi. Phi is a homomorphism from R by S on to R dash. Thus, we have shown that phi is 1 to 1 on to and homomorphism. And hence, phi is an isomorphism of R by S onto R dash. That is, R by S is isomorphic to R dash. that is every homomorphic image or dash of a ring R is isomorphic to the quotient ring R by S. This completes the theorem.